guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So in this video, I will show you something interesting. Okay, Vampire Sanctuary. Guess what? I have actually cleared this with Eventum as the last boss. Hi, Eventum. Okay, so now, aren't you curious about how I did this? You know, it actually seems impossible to beat. And usually, even players with like 4K powers only able to clear until like battle 8, 9 or 10 maybe. So I actually beat them all like this. And if you realize that every time the stage proceeds, the enemy's power is getting bigger and bigger. I mean, higher and higher. Yeah, something like this. So in the end, I beat the stage 15, 3700 power. And before this, I actually beat even this one have more power, 3900. You know, I beat this with a squad that has 3700 powers. Okay, so I'm gonna explain how I do this. Let's reset. Reset. Okay, start. I'm gonna show you how. It's actually the best method. You don't need to bring 15. Well, if you can bring 15, it's a lot better since you can have more backups. But I actually beat this with only 5 heroes. So 10 is more than enough, especially if the heroes level are maxed out. I only have like 6 heroes that have more than 50 levels, and the others are 39, 22, 24, and 18. The others are 50 and 52, 53, and 66. Okay, so let's do it. And for the potions, I recommend the attack potions, especially for this method. So okay, let's do it with attack potion. Go and confirm. Well, actually you can call this as an exploit, but I confirmed this with the cherry credits representative, and she said that the game is actually designed this way. And so I'm gonna show it to you guys. So battle 1, you can see the power of your opponent, 2300, so it's much lower than my power. So as for the beginning, I usually gonna use Ara as my leader like this. So let's go, so that I don't need to lose too much HP. And by the way, before the battle starts, you can see each level of the opponent's heroes, so you can decide which one to beat first. Well, since they are weak, I'm just gonna start to beat from this one. Okay, something like this. Oops, overkill. Okay, it's okay. I guess I can just swipe it like this. Okay, so basically it's still easy. So I'm gonna show an interesting method after this. As for the first battle, try to not lose any of your hero, or do not use any item. Okay, something like this. Victory. Okay, this one is kinda stronger than before, so for now, let's say, oh, I want to spam my ultis here, something like this. And you think that, oops, they are too weak. I did a mistake. I should have saved my ulti for the next battle or something. Now, you can press escape. It's still in Chinese, but I'm pretty sure it's an escape button. Okay, so now you can re-challenge it. Battle, you can even change your leader. something like this. Well, War Maiden's leader skill can give more damage to ulti skills, something like this. And yeah, and did you realize that the ultis of my Ron and Hell Messenger, the middle one, are back? I've used them and they are back. So basically, if you press escape, even if you use your all of your ultis and you use your items, if you press escape, it will reset it. It will back as if you never use the ulti, you never use the item. Okay, so for now I'm just gonna use one ulti here. I think I can kill. Okay, so it's now a lot better than using both Ron and Hell Messenger's ulti. And now I can finish this one with this and this one. Okay, so this way I can actually choose the best way to win without losing any hero, without using any item. Well, as for the item, try to not use any item until you reach battle 14 or 15. Okay, so let's battle the next one. This one's pretty weak, so I'm just gonna use another War Maiden as my lead and use one ulti. Okay, so I can kill them like this one by one. Okay. Oops. Close enough. I think I'm gonna kill this one first. And this one with this. Okay, sounds like a perfect plan. Yeah, so you can actually choose the way you win. So, if you attack and accidentally lost your hero, I mean one of your hero death, just press escape and it will get reset to normal. Okay, this is a perfect example. My Ron's HP is low, so I'm gonna use Ron like this, and I will try to kill another one. This will be able to kill this, and which one should... Okay, so I'm gonna try to use my ulti here. And I think I can kill this one. Or no? Oh, close. Okay, perfect. So my Ron got killed. In this kind of situation, I will definitely press escape and retry. Battle. And I can start from the beginning, so I can fix my mistakes. Okay, so I killed this with this, and this time I'm not gonna use my World Maiden's ulti, but I'm gonna use it for this one. Boom, and it's a lot better, I think. Okay, so if in this turn my Ron is not dead, great, I'm gonna continue the battle. I'm gonna heal. And I'm gonna kill Aura Force. Okay. War Maiden is usually the toughest one, so you can kill him later. Okay. Okay. You can actually know when the opponent is gonna use ultimate attack. Okay, here, Lin. See this Lin? She's gonna do ultimate attack on the next turn. So I'm gonna guard my warrior here. Well, if you want to save, actually it's better to guard them all. Okay, the ultimate attack hits my War Maiden and my War Maiden survive because I guard. Okay, something like that. So now let's kill this one. Pah! And finish this one. You can actually take your time here if none of your unit getting killed. Okay, so yeah, so smooth, of course. So I'm gonna continue this until I win the 15th round. So basically that's how I did this until battle 15. Well, so if you are busy, I'm getting bored to do this. Okay, so I'm gonna do another normal quest. You can just press back and you can go back again to continue your battle until you press reset. So that's how. And yeah, in the middle of battle you can actually raise your hero's level. For example, my war mage's level is 66. If I raise her level into like 70, when I re-enter the vampire sanctuary here, my war maiden's level will become 70 also. However, the SP gauge, heroes, HP, the items will remain as it is, so it won't get changed. Now basically you can just keep trying until you feel that it's impossible and you can just give up and reset the vampire sanctuary. Okay, so I hope you guys can clear your vampire sanctuary after watching this video, and I think that's all for now. Thank you for watching guys, see you again next time, and bye bye. Bloodline, bye.